Alright guys, so in this video we're watching, she wants us to do a dihybrid cross. This means that we are crossing two different traits and we want to see what will happen if we cross them. So the two traits that we're crossing are seed color and seed shape. And so there are different genotypes possible. For seed color, we're going to say that if you have either this genotype or this genotype, you will be green, which means that the capital Y is dominant. If you have two recessive alleles, you are yellow. For seed shape, we will say that this and this are both round, and we will say that this genotype is wrinkled. And so the dominant allele is round and the recessive is wrinkled. And so we want to see what will happen if we cross two individuals that have this genotype for seed color and this genotype for seed shape. We're going to do that between two individuals. And so this one will be the male, and this one will be the female. And we want to see what will happen. So let's do this together. Here is the male. And here is the female. They have the same genotype for both genes. So before I get started with this, I just want to point out how most people do this wrong. We need to have two steps. There's two steps to doing this. Step one is find out what the gametes are. And step two is do the Punnett. So two T's, I can't remember. Punnett square. Sometimes people just go straight for the Punnett square. So if you do this, that is incorrect. And the reason that is incorrect is because these represent gametes, sperm or egg. You must pass every gene that you have to your children. Only one copy of every gene, but every gene must be there. These gametes are missing either a Y or an R. That would be like having a son or a daughter that was missing an eye color gene, or the genes necessary to make their arms or legs. You can't just not give genes to your kids. And so every single one of these boxes should contain a Y and an R. But that's not the case here, because we went straight into step two. We need to do step one first. And so I want to show you what step one is all about, the gametes. How do we make the gametes first? To make the gametes, we have to consider every possible way that these diploid parents might make haploid cells. Haploid means only one copy of every gene, whereas diploid means two. And so we need to get one copy of Y and one copy of R. And we need to think of every possibility that could exist. And so for the father, for example, I know that capital Y could pair with the big R, or capital Y could pair with the small R. I know that the lowercase y could also pair with the big R or the small R. And so those are 1, 2, 3, 4 different genotypes for sperm because it's the father. That is one method to do it, where you just think about what the possibilities are. The other one is called foiling, and a lot of people prefer this method. FOIL is an acronym that you might be familiar with from algebra, where you do your first, outer, inner, and last combinations. Notice that we got the same thing from when I did it. But maybe you like foiling better because you're used to it from math. It's up to you how you do it, but that is our four possible gametes. And so now I have completed step one. Step one was to get our gametes, so let's just write that down. For the father, For the father, we could get this gamete. Or this gamete, or this one, or this one. And for the mother, it was the same. Now we can go to step two. We put the fathers here, and we'll put the mothers here. Oops, this is the father. And so the father's sperm would go here. That's one possibility. Here is another. Here is another. And here's the last. Then we just do the same for the mother. And now we simply add them together. I like to put letters that are the same together because then the phenotype is more obvious to me. So for example, I know that there is one possibility here where the offspring would be green and round. This one would also be green because there's two capital Ys. And heterozygous for round, so also round. This one would also be green and round. And this one would also be green and round. This one would be green and round. And this one would be green and wrinkled. This would be green and round. This would be green and wrinkled. Green, round, green, round. Yellow, round. Yellow, round, green, round, green, wrinkled, yellow, round, and then yellow, wrinkled. That is a dihybrid cross. And so again, remember the steps. Number one, you have to make haploid cells. Number two, you make the Punnett square. Don't forget to do step one. It is the most important part. To do step one, you can do the foil method. Make sure that you check yourself on your gametes. Your gametes must have only one copy of every gene. So you would never want something like this. That would not be a gamete. And you would never want a gamete that would just be like this. That would not also not be a gamete because you're missing genes. If you follow those rules, you should do just fine.